Dear student, now let's study a very important concept, that is carrier concentration in extrinsic semiconductors. We already discussed that in extrinsic semiconductors, due to addition of impurity, carrier concentration changes. Some facts we can write that in N-type semiconductor, as we have discussed in N-type semiconductor, we add donor impurity which donates an extra electron to conduction band. So we can write that electron concentration increases above the intrinsic concentration. And hole concentration decreases below the intrinsic concentration. As we already discussed, continuous electron hole pair generation takes place, and if electron concentration increases, recombination of electrons with hole also increases, due to which hole concentration decreases below the pure semiconductor. Similarly, we can write in P-type semiconductor, hole concentration increases, because we have discussed in P-type, we use acceptor impurity which extract extra electrons corresponding to each impurity atom from valence band and create an extra hole without transfer of any electron to conduction band. So, we can write in P-type semiconductor, hole concentration increases above the intrinsic concentration, and electron concentration decreases below the intrinsic concentration. And there are several experiments which were done on these concepts of study of carrier concentration as well as electron hole pair generation and recombination. And we can also write that it has also been proved. This is a fact you always need to keep in mind, because it is going to be used in various problems, that it has also been proved that in thermal equilibrium, we are talking about the lattice with the surrounding. If its temperature is constant, the product of electron and hole concentration does not depend on donor or acceptor doping, and it is given as this, the product of electron and hole concentration is always equal to the square of intrinsic concentration, which depends only on temperature. So even if we increase or decrease donor or acceptor impurity, the product of Ne and NH will remain constant. And this has been proved by various analysis, theoretical as well as experiment. And this particular law we call a mass action law for carrier concentration. And it is quite useful for handling various numericals related to carrier concentration in extrinsic semiconductor. Using the mass action law, we can define easily the concentration, independent concentration of holes and electrons. We can write for a P-type semiconductor, if Na is the concentration of acceptor impurity atoms, that is, say if we have added aluminium as acceptor impurity atom, Na is the concentration for aluminium atoms. So we know that each aluminium will be responsible of one for one extra hole in valence band. So we can write as number of holes in p-type semiconductors are very large compared to number of electrons. This implies we can take hole concentration to be approximately equal to acceptor concentration, because the intrinsic electron hole pair generation will be negligible compared to Na. So, in a p-type semiconductor, electron concentration can be directly given by mass action law, thus that is Ni square by hole concentration, that will be Na. So, this gives us the electron concentration in p-type semiconductor, which are minority charge carriers, and hole concentration in p-type semiconductors is approximately equal to the concentration of acceptor impurity atoms. Similarly, we can write for a given n-type semiconductor, if ND is the concentration of donor impurity atoms, then in this situation we know as in an n-type semiconductor, electron concentration is very large compared to that of holes, because each donor impurity like phosphorus, one extra electron is given to conduction band without any extra hole. So, we can write that electron concentration in n-type semiconductors approximately equal to the concentration of donor impurity atoms. This implies hole concentration can be given by mass action law, that is NH can be written as Ni square by ND. This will give us the concentration of holes in a given n-type semiconductor. So, these relations will be used whenever you need to make any analysis based on charge carrier concentration in various problems.